Welcome, 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 and thank you for spending some of your time with us. My name is Tina Rosenquist, and this is Knowledge for Wellness. And this show is to better inform you, because the more information you have, the better decisions you can make. And knowledge is power. And today's topic is on natural and organic products. And bringing us this great information is Cassie Kuhn of Casa Organic Salon. Mm-hmm. And you are located in Minneapolis, Minnesota?
I am.
Wow. Well, welcome, Cassie.
Thank you, Tina.
I'm so glad that you could be here. You're one of the first organic salons.
Yes. It's very exciting.
Yes. And you are making headway mm-hmm. for mm-hmm. a lot of things mm-hmm. to become better for a lot of people.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And I kind of want to talk a little bit about, you know, you being the first, you introducing mm-hmm. organic. And my viewers haven't met you, and mm-hmm. so I really want you to tell them why you decided to do this, the birth of your salon,
yeah.
and why this passion and your love for this. So go ahead. Yeah, that'd be great.
Okay. Well, Tina, it's really been about an 11-year journey. You know, I started at the Aveda Institute here in Minneapolis, which mm-hmm. really birthed in me the importance of plant-derived ingredients and using botanical ingredients and essential oils. So it really created a foundation mm-hmm. for me to understand this kind of other concept of beauty.
Yes.
So from there, I worked with Aveda for about 6 years mm-hmm. and got into doing some Pilates and teaching yoga and some of my other part of my love, which is wellness.
Mm-hmm.
And really started to see firsthand of how important our lifestyle integrated into my career as a cosmetologist.
Sure.
So from about 5-6 years into my journey, I started teaching nutrition classes and things of that nature.
Yeah.
And I started to get sick at the salon. So even with that said, working in Aveda salons, mm-hmm. we were still very busy and we were doing a lot of hair color. So started to go home with migraines mm-hmm. and things of that nature. And with the past knowledge that I had, I knew why. So I was left with a decision. I either leave the industry or I come up with a new concept and do something a little bit different and pioneer into what I know is the future of my industry. Mm-hmm. And that's natural and organic products that are result-orientated, but just are delivered in a different way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And we're hearing so much about toxins in our environment.
Yeah.
We're not really understanding a lot of why these children are getting so sick so young.
Mm-hmm.
And here it is out and mm-hmm. right there, all the toxins that we put in. And did you ever think mm-hmm. that you would actually have to maybe step back because of the chemical ingredients?
No. Yeah. You know, when you think about hairdressers, you think, well, they're on their feet all the time and you only last, you know, so many years because it's taxing on your bodies. But mm-hmm. there's a very underground thing that goes on in our industry, and that of bladder cancer and some different cancers and some other immunity diseases that, you know, as hairdressers, are just kind of, you just kind of leave the industry and exit out. And mm-hmm. there's this always this new, you know, rambunctious young woman always stepping into the industry to take it over. So there's this turnover that I think has been dismissed. And we're starting to see more and more of it in the industry. And that's one of the reasons I wanted to open the salon is to, one, educate other stylists mm-hmm. and other skin, you know, therapists and massage therapists on what their options are.
Sure.
And to then begin to educate other stylists, too, on the different modalities that we can use.
Right. Mm-hmm. And it's just so great because now it seems that a lot of people are becoming more and more aware of actually even anything that they're putting on their bodies and lotion, because we're using progesterone cream on
our arms.
And, you know, the actual sunscreens that we're mm-hmm. putting on, and you need vitamin D.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 60% of those toxins go into the blood. I mean, it's an instant uptake into that dermal, into the blood.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if you think about it, it doesn't have to pass into the liver for it to be cleaned out
mm-hmm.
and then to enter into, you know, the streams of biochemically in the body. So it is a very serious matter. And, you know, women will put on anywhere from 6 to 21 products a day, if you think about it.
Yes.
You've got, you know, some women wear their sunscreen, but you've got your toothpaste, your deodorant, your lotion, your oils, your skin products, your hair products. Mm-hmm. And when they're all filled with those toxins, it's a bioaccumulative effect on the body. So we're seeing a lot more people with environmental sensitivities and immunity issues, and that's toxic overload.
Yes.
So one place for women to start is to think about their rituals every day. What skincare are you using? You know, what products are you putting on your children? Children are very small, and their little bodies take in those toxins very abrasively.
Yeah.
So,
and to even think, you know, by the time we're even in the shower trying to get clean using those products, and then you come out and you've got your deodorant and you're brushing your teeth, and by the time we walk out of our house, what would
don't forget your perfume.
Oh yes,
your phthalates, your fragrance.
Yes.
So
And you walk out of the house, what if you've already used maybe 15 to 20 products?
It
is amazing. So we've already kind of actually put this into our body, and we absorb it the remainder of our 24 hours. And the only time we actually get clean is when we do take that shower again.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
And even I know I'm real sensitive to certain soaps in the shower. Yes.
Yeah, a lot of the surfactants are really hard on the skin. I mean, it's literally degreaser.
Yeah.
So
now we're talking a salon. And we're not just talking about hair. You know, you do the full body and makeup and products like that, which is really great. So how does your salon actually promote beauty care then?
We really look at it as a, I hate to use the word holistic, but a holistic. I study functional medicine. So when I see a client and they come in, you know, I can start to address anything from hair loss, and which usually goes into a hormonal conversation.
Right.
And if they need referrals, I can give them to referrals through a lot of really, really great individuals that I know of. And then we kind of go into face shape. You know, what is your face shape? What looks great on you? What do we need to pull out in your look, the body types, all of that. So we have everything from a regular beauty consultation to talking about hormones. We sell omegas. Omegas are great for the skin. We sell probiotics. Our gut health shows in our face.
Yes.
So we sell a great line of probiotics from a local company called ImmunoViva. And then going into a little bit deeper of the, you know, rituals that we talk about with beauty, we have Kesia Natural Skincare.
Okay.
And that's a botanical line, and it's comprised of vitamins, minerals, phospholipids. The way that we deliver skincare into the skin is important.
Yes.
So we've built the minerals and vitamins and things of that nature to go into a fat that drives it into the skin, so it's actually delivering into the skin.
Oh, so it's getting absorbed.
Yes. We've got a great eye cream, but not toxic to the skin, and it's going to actually support, build the skin back up versus hiding things and breaking it down over time.
Okay.
Yeah. And then one thing that, you know, the salon is has really grown on is our ammonia-free hair color.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. That is the hot topic.
It's the hot topic in the industry now, too, because you see L'Oreal just launched an ammonia-free hair color line. There's another, you know, about three lines out there that I could spit off. But the line that we use is from Masté. And Mr. Masté is from Paris. And he's one of the only three chemists left in the industry that is actually a hairdresser as well. So he gets the integrity of the hair.
Right.
And he came out with the first sodium lauryl sulfate shampoo back in 1981.
Wow.
30 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And how we deliver our hair color without the ammonia is through a plant derivative that opens up the pH balance of that cuticle. So we do not have ammonia, and we do not have, and this is the key point, MEA, which is called ethanolamine. And ethanolamine is the silent substitute that they use in these ammonia-free hair colors.
Okay.
So the key thing to remember about ethanolamine is it not only damages the hair, what happens is it blasts open and breaks down the tyrosine, which is an amino acid in the hair. When you lose that, you can't keep the hair color. It constantly fades.
Okay.
Ethanolamine is actually also an adhesive. So every time you wash the hair, the hair oxidizes, releases the hair color. and then it's also a carcinogen.